Battlefront 2 just had its best hero release since it came out back in 2017. The BB update is now live, and it brought a bunch of great content features to the game, including a couple of new maps, an update to the Supremacy mode, and our first new heroes in almost a year. In today's video, we're going to recap all the new content that came with the January BB update, showcase some changes that you might have missed, and talk about what makes this the best hero release Battlefront has gotten so far. Be sure to hit the thumbs up button and subscribe to keep up with all things Star Wars Battlefront. So now let's check it out. Here's a recap of all the new content this month. The BB update is so named because it introduces two new astromech droid heroes into Battlefront 2. BB-8 joins the roster of the light side, and BB-9E is the new villain for the dark side. These are the first two new heroes that Battlefront has gotten since Anakin and Dooku dropped back in early 2019, and they bring the total number of heroes on either side up to 11, for a grand total of 22 heroes in Battlefront 2. As a hero and villain of the sequel era, they come with an update to Capital Supremacy and Instant Action, where we get to play on the sequel era maps Jakku, Takodana, and Agent Kloss in both modes. In Supremacy mode specifically, we also have two new Capital Ship interior maps, the MC-85 Star Cruiser for the Resistance and the Resurgent class Star Destroyer for the First Order. These two new locations are available from any sequel era map when playing Supremacy mode. Agent Kloss, the newest map to come to Battlefront 2, is also now available in the Hero Showdown rotation, and rounding out the list of content is a new emote each for both Finn and Kylo Ren. That's a pretty stacked content drop, and all of this is now available for all players who have not yet downloaded the new update. So now, let's explore some of this new content. The two new emotes for Finn and Kylo Ren are event items. You have to complete a milestone for each hero in order to unlock the new emote. All you have to do is get 100 eliminations with each hero, specifically in the co-op mode. If you get kills in Galactic Assault or Capital Supremacy, it will not count towards this milestone. Getting the 100 eliminations with each one will grant you the Thumbs Up emote for Finn and the Showdown emote for Kylo Ren. The two BB droids also came with emotes and victory poses, but if you tried to unlock them in the Collections menu, you may have noticed that it says that they're available in crates. As most of us know by now, Battlefront 2 no longer has a crate system. We don't even get daily crates, which used to award credits at the beginning of our sessions. I'm assuming this is just holdover script that did not get updated, but just like Kylo and Finn, you unlock the emotes and victory poses for the droids by completing milestones for each hero. These milestones will have either something to do with getting a set number of score with the hero, or performing a certain number of eliminations with a particular ability. You can see and track the progress of these milestones in the Career tab, and you can see how close you are to completing any given one. The game menu also underwent some changes that were not outlined in the patch notes for the BB update. There's a new tab in the multiplayer screen called More, which actually is where the majority of the game modes got moved to. Under Multiplayer, there's now a Supremacy tab, a tab for the Hero and Villain modes, and then a new More tab, which contains every other game mode. The likes of Galactic Assault, Strike, and Starfighter Assault can now be found in this tab, so if you can't seem to find the modes in the menu, be sure you're looking there. Supremacy mode got its own tab because it now has an era selector just like co-op mode, where you can choose to either fight in the Age of the Republic or the Age of the Resistance. In the next couple of months, this tab will be completed with the Age of Rebellion, where we'll be able to choose to fight in all three eras in Capital Supremacy. In honor of this, Capital Supremacy underwent a name change during the BB update and is now simply known as Supremacy Mode. Even though the sequel maps are new to the mode and we've never played in the new Capital Ship interiors before, the flow of Supremacy in the sequel era is basically the exact same as the prequels. The ground phase is spent running around capturing command posts, and the first team to 100 points gets to make their way to the opposing team's Capital Ship to try to destroy it from the inside. Just like with the prequel era, the ship phase of Supremacy contains two phases. The first phase being where you have to capture an objective area, and the second phase where you actually destroy the critical system itself. The new ship interiors play great, and visually they're fantastic. They both borrow assets from existing Capital ship maps in the campaign, just with a bunch of visual improvements, new textures, and other things like that. The MC-85 actually feels like a giant rebel ship, and the First Order Star Destroyer has kind of a cyberpunk vibe to it, which I really dig. Right now, these new ship interiors are only available in sequel-era Supremacy mode. But just like with the prequel ship interiors, they might be brought to other modes like Heroes vs. Villains in later updates. Besides all of this content, the BB update also brought a bunch of hero changes, bug fixes, quality of life improvements, and much more to the game. There's even a couple of new animations in the front-end menu for some of the heroes like Rey, Darth Vader, and Bossk. This update, and everything that went into it, is definitely up there in terms of one of the better updates that Battlefront 2 has ever had. It comes just in time for some really fun in-game events happening this month, including Heroes Unleashed, where we'll get to play as BB-8 and BB-9E alongside 9 other heroes and villains in Galactic Assault. Heroes Unleashed will take place between February 7th and February 10th. Following that, there's a Boots on the Ground event where we get to play as no heroes in the large-scale modes, and that takes place from the 14th to the 17th. So you'll definitely want to get your Astromech fix during Heroes Unleashed, or just stick to Heroes vs. Villains for that weekend. From the 21st to the 24th is a Reinforcement event where we get to play as more reinforcements than normal and their battle point cost is reduced, and finally we close out the month with a triple XP weekend, which you'll definitely want to participate in if you're trying to get those epic cards for BB-8 and BB-9E quickly. So now let's go back and talk about the two new droid heroes, because we still have to go over why this is the best hero drop Battlefront 2 has had since 2017. So Battlefront 2 launched in November of 2017, and the first DLC update was just a month after that in December. That update introduced Krayt as a new planet in Galactic Assault, and Finn and Captain Phasma as new heroes. One of the things that made that update unique, though, was the fact that both heroes dropped at the same time. We got a light side hero and a dark side hero on the same day. Every consecutive hero drop after that, though, was done differently. We would get the villain of the update on the first month, and then the following month we would get their counterpart for the light side. This made it feel like we were getting steady, consistent content updates every single month, but some players felt that the pace was a little bit slow and drip-fed. Releasing the heroes one per month also had a little bit of unnecessary baggage attached to it. It wasn't the best way to go about hero drops. Players are essentially fighting their own teammates to be the first one to try out the new hero, and if you missed your chance, you'd probably be better off finding a different lobby and trying again. More than that though, the fact that the heroes and villains are locked to one faction or the other made it difficult to play as the hero that you wanted to if you did not get matchmade onto the right side. For example, when Count Dooku dropped, if you wanted to play as Count Dooku, you obviously had to be on the dark side. If you matchmade into Heroes vs. Villains trying to play as Dooku, but you got put on the light side, you simply will not get your chance until possibly the next round. This caused a lot of players to back out of lobbies early if they did not get put on the side that they wanted. This would lead to only half full lobbies, or stop the game from starting altogether, unless of course the players just did not mind not playing as the new hero. With the release of Finn and Phasma, this wasn't as much of an issue, since no matter which side you got matchmade on, you had the potential to play as the new hero, and this is the exact same case with BB-8 and BB-9E. Since both heroes dropped at the same time, you don't have to back out of a lobby if you want to play as a new hero. You have an equal chance no matter which side you're on. Of course, if you're specifically trying to play as BB-8 or specifically trying to play as BB-9E, that's understandable. And naturally, we're still going to be fighting against our teammates to get to the hero first, but at the very least, we won't have to keep re-lobbying just to get an opportunity to play as a new hero. We'll have the opportunity every game. And that's why this is the best hero drop Battlefront 2 has had since it released. This feels like a legitimate hero update. We have a new hero for the light side and a new hero for the dark side, plus new maps to try them on. If DICE ever develops more heroes for future updates, I would hope they would go about the release of those heroes in the same way they went about releasing BB-8 and BB-9E, one hero on each side at the same time. The only downside I could see from that is that the following month after the hero release would seem really small in comparison, but I don't think most players would mind. The positives definitely outweigh the negatives, and I think this is the best way to go about hero drops in Battlefront 2. And with that, that brings us to the end of our content recap and why this is the best hero drop Battlefront 2 has ever had. In a comment below, let me know your favorite part about the new update, and also let me know which of the two droids you like better. If you guys enjoy these content recaps going over all the major game updates, let me know by giving this video a thumbs up so I know to keep doing them in the future. But with that, that's going to do it from me. I appreciate you all stopping by the bazaar, and I'll see you out on the battlefront. Peace!